We're going to be talking about four main things today, and this is going to all revolve around your routine, the 24 hours, what you're reviewing, and the job description and resume. Let's jump in and start talking about routines. First off and foremost, routines.
I like routine.
So when we talk about preparing, a lot of people get out of their everyday routines. And this is where the first things first, start reviewing and kind of auditing. What do you do? What is your daily routine? What do you do on a normal basis that we can replicate? Far too often what I see is people start preparing for these interviews and they start doing these things they've never done before. And I'm all for trying new things, trying out new processes, new routines, but just because you want to try it one time does not make it a routine, and that can put you outside of your comfort zone. That cannot help. It can potentially help, but normally it doesn't, because people do these crazy things to where it's like they stay up all late thinking if they cram a bunch in before the interview, they'll be good. And they do stuff that they haven't maybe done even since college. It just is not worth it. My question then is to you is, what is your routine? What have you been doing when you get up every morning? What have you been doing when you get home from work every day? Or if you don't have a job right now, what does this routine you do look like normally? Where do you structure time in to learn or to study or to prepare? Because we want to take a look at your routine and start preparing for how you want to prepare for this. So knowing, let's say your interview is a week out, what can we do? What routines do you already have that we can reuse or build upon and do every day, not just one day, do every day to get you prepared for the interview?
Gotta study.
A lot of this can look like getting up before work, studying, getting home, studying, dedicating time right before you go to sleep. There's a lot of little things you can do here, but the question gets back to your routine. What can work and where can we add more time to prepare you for? And what do you need to study? What haven't you learned that this resume talks about, or this job description might talk about? And so building out a routine is the first thing I want to point you to preparing for. Looking at yours and how can you make it better to prepare for this interview. Plan the 24 hours before. This is also a key. This is the number two tip/step/whatever you want to call it. You need to plan out your 24 hours before. That way, going into that last 24 hours, you know everything's going to happen, because this is going to help with your confidence of the situation. This is going to help with how you take on the moment, because no matter what you do, there's going to be nerves. There's going to be the feeling of the imposter syndrome.
We have an imposter aboard.
There's going to be a lot of things happening, and to where you will be feeling a lot of different things. And one of the easiest ways you can help yourself out is to set the 24-hour window of what is going to happen, from when you plan to wake up, what you plan to do, to how early you plan to show up, what are you going to eat potentially, and basically plan out the 24 hours. So looking at your routines, and now moving on to looking at your 24-hour window and blocking that all out and figuring what you need to do to be successful for yourself, because everyone's path to success can be a little bit different. The third tip here is review what you studied and put that into the 24 hours from before we were just talking about. Find a spot for that in the 24 hours and put what you've studied in the routines. So if you know you're going for a Node.js interview and you just went to a boot camp, you learned about Node, find where all the content is, or hopefully you have some notes that you can study and review. Now, going back through the whole curriculum something can be very hard, and I get that. But if you have broken down notes to study every night, every time you get a break, this can be extremely helpful. And planning that into the 24-hour window and not overwhelming yourself, but putting it into the 24-hour window can be key. Also, putting in your routines, say every night or every morning, every lunch break, can be very key for when you study. Fourth tip, and the last but not least, is to read the job description and the resume. The job descriptions can give you a lot of tail signs of what the interview is going to be like, what it's going to be about, and what the company is, who they are, what they do. And reading this job description and every piece of it can give you some questions to study for, which is very, very useful. So first and foremost on this section, read the job description thoroughly. Trust me, it'll be very helpful. At the same time, also read your resume very thoroughly, because a lot of questions that can get pulled when they're not geared towards the job description, they're more often than not geared towards your resume and what your experiences are on there and kind of what it tells people and how it markets you, because that's where we pull questions from when we're not pulling from the job description. So with these 4 points, now there's a lot of other things you can do. You'll see more videos from me here in the future, but I want to make sure you know these 4 are key. And if you guys request or would like more, leave some comments. I can go in depth more into some of the routines and some of the 24-hour planning. But those are the 4 things I want you guys to start thinking about. Let me know if you have any questions, and I will see you in the next video.